You know, this is a place where everyone knew about. The word on the street was that there is this archive on the top floor of a tongao where he kept everything. The first thing that you notice is that smell of old stuff, of paper, and this just whiff of history, and it continues to unfold. Then it's bookshelf after bookshelf. It just becomes an environment that envelops you.
Ha Bik Chuen was born in 1925 and passed away in 2009. He was a Hong Kong-based artist. However, everyone knew him as the uncle who would go and photograph every single exhibition he went to in the city. Here you have, we think, around 40 years of Hong Kong's art history taken up by one man.
If this becomes publicly available for use, it can change the way that we see and write art history. For Ha, to have done what he did, he had to have had a pretty amazing partner. And I think this was what we all felt with Mrs. Ha. She's the sweetest lady, always kind of very cheerful. The relationship is just about being present. The studio was not in a very good state, and so part of the project is to actually relocate the archive. So we were in kind of teams of twos or threes, just packing, and they would have to stop because there's literally no more space to pack. I have a lot of empathy and respect for the laborers who were moving, because at one point we were packing as quickly or even faster than they were moving. So they would have moved four boxes and we would have packed another six. So it was like the work would never end. First, we have to shelve the boxes and we have to kind of get intellectual control over them. And then we need to find out what's in what box. And then we can actually begin doing some research, identify some areas of interest and priorities where we want to look into. Ha's archive was not boring. Anyone who went would remember that it was full of colors, it was playful. And people who work in the arts or the archive take themselves too seriously. So there's also a little conspiracy in this project, which is a very open conspiracy to make it fun and serious at the same time. It's possible to do both. I think it's also just this need for people to relate to one another. There's just something that speaks to every single one of us from this archive. You know, this collection is never ours to begin with. It started with the generosity of one man and his family, and it then becomes our collective responsibility to share it.